many of us dream about writing a book, and Deb Abela worked hard at writing and has learned how to get her books published. She is a successful author and she's here to share her tips with us now. Deb, thanks very much for joining us. How difficult was it to write your first book, and where did you get the idea from?
Oh, in fact, writing the first book was easy because there was almost no pressure. There were no deadlines, there were no publishers expecting anything. So I just sat down, had this idea for a book and wrote it and had the most amazing fun. So I write kids' books. So, and my first series of books were about spies and splat and goo. So it was really, really fun.
And it seems like every man and his dog is writing a kids' book at the moment. Yes. How do you get yours out there? How do you cut through that and get it published?
And that's the problem, isn't it? I mean, I think everyone can write a book, but I, of course, think that. Everyone's got a story in them. Mm. But it's about selling that story to the publisher and selling it in a way that kids are going to love this. Kids are going to really...
Did you just send them, like, a synopsis of your book?
The publishing's changed since I started. So about 12 years ago I started. And now it's a really different fish. So now it's largely online. So once upon a time when I was publishing, you'd send your big manuscript in, it'd cost you a lot in postage, you'd wait for 6 months, maybe you would hear, maybe you wouldn't.
And did you just, like, find them in the Yellow Pages, or did you get a meeting with them?
And found them in the Yellow Pages, the equivalent of that first up. But now it's all online. So what you need to do if you do have a great idea and you finished your novel, your picture book, your idea, go online and find out what the publishers want from you. So some of them, for example, still want that big manuscript sent in.
With a stamped addressed envelope so that it can be returned.
Yes, if you want it
back. As one who has read many manuscripts, and I have to tell you, Deb, I don't agree with you, not everybody can write a book.
Everybody probably has a story in them. Is it better to say that?
But it's writing it that's
the No, and it is. It's the delivery. A great story needs to be delivered well.
But you want an unknown author?
Yes.
Now that's the big dilemma here.
Yes.
An unknown. So,
but again,
how did you get the first book published? Because that's the key.
That is. So I sent it to 6 different publishers and I thought, I'm going to start at the top. I'm going to start at the big publishing houses. And if they say no, I'll work my way down.
And so that would be like Penguin, Random House.
Pan Macmillan, yes, yeah. Alan Unwin, all the big ones. Mm-hmm. And 5 of them said no. But really nice no's. Like, no one said to me, you really need to give it away and become a plumber. Yeah. Like, you know.
They weren't just pro forma letters.
No,
they were quite
actually
personal.
Were personal letters, and that is rare.
That's nice.
So they all
said... So what then
said,
do you do next?
Well, next I just
Can
sat around...
Can I just interrupt for a second? Because if you got a personal letter, that means they saw something in you.
That's right.
Yeah.
But it didn't quite fit their list.
Yeah, sorry.
And they'd publish something very similar and there's no point publishing 2 books that are going to compete with each other. So luckily, though, about a year later, Random House did send me a letter. They left a message on my answering machine and said, we love the book. Have you sold it yet? No. Not to anybody. We'd like for you to come in, let's have a chat, and we'd like more in this series of books because we really, really like these kids that you've come up with. And that's kind of how it started.
Did they change it much? Did they give you an editor? Oh, fantastic.
No, and I have to say, so I've largely worked with Random House and they're beautiful. They're very, very collegiate.
Yep.
They're very, very... They want to work with you. It's your work.
So you are answer to J.K. Rowling.
No. No, and I have many, many author friends who are all delightful and talented and wonderful. And I think the Australian publishing industry, particularly where kids are concerned, very healthy.
Yeah.
Deb, before
exciting.
We wrap up, I just want to ask, because everyone on this panel besides me has written a book.
Okay.
All of those have been non-fiction. All of those have been non-fiction. Is fiction a better way to crack into it, or...?
Oh, it's about your idea.
Okay.
It really is about your idea. If you have an absolute kicking idea and you can translate that, then brilliant.
I have written one fiction book.
Have you?
Mm.
Well, let's just look at some points, some tips on how to get published. Work hard, write what you know and love, research the market, research the right publisher, be optimistic, realistic, and don't give up. Deb, thank you very much for coming in and chatting with us. Hopefully that spurs on a potential writer out there to take their book even further. Mm.